I'm Jared Brooke, Extension Wildlife Specialist with Purdue University, here with another wildlife habitat hint. We're standing in a native warm season grass field that we burned on August 5th. And we're going to talk about some of the reasons why you might consider a late growing season burn as opposed to a dormant season prescribed fire. The conventional wisdom and one of the most common management practices that's been recommended for CRP fields or native grass fields has been prescribed fire in the dormant season. But there's a lot of reasons why you might consider burning these fields during the late growing season, which typically is August, September, and even into early October. One of the best reasons to consider a late growing season prescribed fire is the increase in forbs the growing season after the fire. So typically in a lot of these conservation or CRP plantings, as time goes on, the amount of forbs or broadleaf plants starts to dwindle and the grass tends to take over. So by using a late growing season fire, you can really increase those forbs that are not only important to wildlife like northern bobwhite, but also to pollinating insects and pollinators in general. So late growing season fire typically provides better control of woody plants as opposed to dormant season burning, which typically just top kills the plants. Woody plants are especially vulnerable at this time of year because they've already spent all their root reserves and they haven't got a chance to take more nutrients back down to the root systems. So another advantage of a late growing season fire is Sericea lesbidesa control. There's a fair amount of research coming out recently that talks about using late growing season fires as a way to help control Sericea, especially if you couple that fire with an herbicide application the following year. Typically, you want to use a late growing season fire prior to Sericea flowering. And that's typically the early September, mid-September timeframe in Indiana. So those August prescribed fires are good for Sericea control. Another benefit of burning during the late growing season is the safety of the fire. So typically fires during the late growing season have shorter flame lengths and spread a lot slower than burns in the dormant season. That makes them a lot easier to control than the burns during the dormant season. The last benefit of late growing season burns is expanding your burn window and the number of days that you can burn throughout the year. See, if you only think about burning in the dormant season, that February through March, April timeframe, you're limited to those 3 months. But if you think about burning during August, September, and October, you've just expanded your burn window by 3 months, allowing you to have more days with the right conditions to burn and potentially burn more acres than in that short 3 month window. When determining how to manage your native grass planting or your CRP field, late growing season burns are another tool in the toolbox, along with dormant season burns, disking, and herbicide that can help you meet your management objectives.